The kitchen. Set in a dystopian future London, all social housing has been eliminated. A young boy named Benji loses his mother and his direction in life until he meets Izzy. The two begin to form a strong bond and have to figure out how to survive the kitchen, a dangerous, poverty-stricken community where the police brutalize the residents to force them to leave. So before I get into this review, guys, I want to quickly apologize for my bad microphone. I don't have access to my good quality stuff right now, so this will have to do. And also, this film was co-directed by Daniel Kaluuya. It's real impressive because it turns out this guy has just as much talent behind the camera as he does in front. I'm really looking forward to seeing his directorial efforts in the future. So, this film is peculiar. Make no mistake, I like it. I just can't think of another film that portrays its bleak future like this. It's very cool seeing a load of ghetto roadmen speaking in today's London slang, but with futuristic technology in the background. This is the first time I've seen this done. Also, most films set in a bleak future tend to be more about finding the answer to the problem, the cure that will save everyone. But The Kitchen goes nowhere near that idea. This is mainly about a man and boy forming a bond. It's very humble considering the atmosphere. It's quite refreshing seeing a world like this through the eyes of a normal person rather than an archetypal hero. But the setting does confuse me a little bit. Although I really appreciate this fresh take on a dystopian future, it wasn't necessary. The story, character arcs, and political messages would have remained intact if they were set in today's world. Plus, it would have saved them so much money making this flick, so it is a bit confusing, but at least it's not distracting, and it does add character to the film. The bond between Izzy and Benji was wonderful. Seeing Benji trying to find a sense of community after losing his mother was just painful. It's heartwarming stuff. And I like how it causes Izzy to learn how to finally take responsibility for someone other than himself. He's been a lone wolf for years, but now he has to learn new tactics when socializing. I think it's lovely. And I really appreciated the nuances between them. It's sometimes about the words not said that gives their chemistry some spark. I was damn surprised to watch this almost epic setting churn out a character drama with no real action. This is fresh. But there were some issues that stopped this film from being great. There's a gang of Utes who offer temptation to Benji. They ride flashy motorbikes and steal for a living. The problem was, I didn't really see them as bad guys. They had a lovely, loyal sense of community, and they mainly steal to survive. Sure, at one point, the leader breaks into a rich family's home and intimidates them, but that just made me see the leader as flawed. I still understood where he was coming from. So when I see this gang fighting against the evil police officers, I have no qualms. I just saw this gang as underdeveloped anti-heroes with anger issues. I don't think the film was going for that. But the biggest issue for me was that the last act became way too jumbled. Izzy and Benji sometimes part ways, go on their own little journeys, too much happens, and nothing really comes of all these little moments. It was odd. And when certain things were revealed, I didn't feel the weight of it. I was like, yeah, I thought the film made this obvious about 20 minutes in. How is this a reveal? Still, in the end, The Kitchen is a decent time and definitely worth a watch. It's touching, well acted, the script is nuanced, and I can't compare it to too much. It feels unique and offers a fresh take on a bleak dystopian future. Sure, some of it is a little contrived and muddy, but that doesn't mean it deserves the mediocre ratings it's been getting recently. Give it a watch, and if you like it, support it, like I am right now, because I want to see more like this. I'm going to give The Kitchen a 6 out of 10. Thanks for watching, guys. Stay jiggy. The better appreciates it.